Good morning, students. Aerial animals. Some features on aerial animals, as you can see on your screen. As you know, aerial animals are those animals that can fly, spend most of the time in air, have two legs. They hatch from eggs, means they give birth to their babies through eggs. Have light bodies with feathers, as we discussed that their bones are hollow so that their bodies are light and they can fly in the air. Have hollow and light bones, mostly fly with their wings. They fly with their wings, as you know. Aerial animals, they have wings which help them to fly. They have light and hollow bones which make their bodies light so that they can fly, and they have their bodies are actually boat shaped which help them to cut through the air and move forward, isn't it? So these are aerial animals, animals that fly are called aerial animals. Birds, insects and bats are aerial animals. Birds have wings, their bodies are boat shape of a boat, because so that they can cut, like aeroplanes you must have seen, help them to cut through the air. Insects have wings, some of the insects like butterflies and moth, they have beautiful colored wings. Bats' wings are actually not wings which you see as in the birds. They don't have feathers, they are made up of flaps of skin. So with the help of the flaps of skins, their wings are not like those of the birds. Okay, and you can see these birds, bats, butterfly, moth, dragonfly. These are some of the animals that can fly in the air, and they have flaps of skin. These bats have flaps of skin. Many insects also have wings, and they cannot fly very high. Insects cannot fly very high, like the birds, like eagle, kite, vultures. You have seen that they can fly very high in the sky. But some animals, you know, like birds, they cannot fly, like ostrich and emu. They are flightless. Birds, they cannot fly though they have wings, because they are very heavy. Other insects, like you have seen dragonfly or even the grasshopper, butterflies, cockroach, housefly, mosquitoes, they all have wings which help them to fly. And these are called aerial animals. Thank you, children.